One of the challenges of treating back pain is that there's so many different anatomic structures that can cause back pain. It could be arthritis in the joints, it could be the muscles, it could be worn out discs, it could be related to the nerves. Fortunately, most cases of back pain are going to get better over time. I think there's been a lot of advancements in spinal surgery that we're trying to incorporate into our daily practices. This may include more biologic solutions. It may be motion-sparing treatments to try to avoid fusion. And it might be less invasive techniques that allow us to place devices through smaller incisions. Spinal fusion is a very common procedure that we perform pretty much on a daily basis. Spinal fusion basically involves taking away motion of the spine. And this can be accomplished by many different techniques. It may involve the placement of screws, cages, but generally we will use some type of implant to fuse the spine. The sacroiliac joint really serves as the link between the spine and the pelvis. In years past, I don't think we really thought that the sacroiliac joint could actually cause pain. It's not a joint that really has much motion, but sometimes it can develop micromotion as a result of degeneration, trauma, childbirth. I think now we've kind of realized that the sacroiliac joint can actually cause back pain. And those are the patients that we really try to treat with these less invasive solutions. So with the minimally invasive sacroiliac joint fusion, what we're really trying to do is stabilize the sacroiliac joint by placing implants across the joint in a less invasive fashion. This is a procedure that should take less than an hour. It's an outpatient procedure, so patients go home the same day. I think certainly here, having been an investigator in the clinical trial, we do have a great deal of experience treating sacroiliac joint pain. This involves not only the diagnosis, but also providing non-operative care. And when patients don't improve, we also have surgical solutions as well. In the future, hopefully we'll be able to apply many of these biologic solutions for other conditions, such as degenerative disc disease or spinal cord injury. I think certainly there have been amazing advancements in spine, whether it's minimally invasive surgery, whether it's the use of navigation, robotic surgery as well. And I think here at Yale, what we strive to do is to apply these new technologies to patient care. What I'd like to emphasize is that every patient is different. We really try to provide individualized care. One size doesn't fit all when it comes to the spine.